Yeah. Okay. So let's see where we're at. Anyway, it's been way too long since I've done one of these retrospectives. So today I'm going through one of the ones who's important to me, and that is Pat Lawlor. Pat Lawlor started out doing independent design. I'm going to get my notes because my memory sucks, but... So he originally was working on a game called Wrecking Ball, and it was independent, and it had a continuous play field going from the play field up into the back glass, which, I mean, sure, back in the 50s there had been a few that used the ball in the back glass, but usually that was a separate ball. Really was not a common feature, certainly expensive. That he ended up getting hired by Williams, and they made it into Banzai Run. Now, it was expensive to make, was moderately well received. They only made like 1,700 units. So for 1988, that's a fairly low production run and probably not a stellar introduction for Pat Lawlor. Now, having said that, had a lot of promise to the design, some neat concepts. The only thing that was probably a first is that it made noises in a track mode if you hit the flipper. So prior to Banzai Run, the way the flippers were wired, they were just starting to use the low voltage switches, which would allow them to flip the flippers without... or have it register flipper switches without actually firing the flipper all the time. So anyway, it's kind of neat technological history. There is no good emulation of Banzai Run, so I can't show you this game to start with. That would have been my preference, would be to start with Pat Lawlor's career. There is a VR version of it available, and there's an older Visual Pinball 9 version as well. Anyway, year two, the first of Pat Lawlor's disaster games was Earthshaker. Now, I've actually been trying to get this to work. And, again, one of the things I'm going to stress about Visual Pinball, which is what I'm using here, is that this is fan made. All of these games are things that are put together by fans. It's not a commercial product, and where people don't always put all the time into everything, they'll get it like 80% there. You can see my display in the back glass. I don't know what's up with that. I've been trying to get that to, yeah, and on it goes. But yeah, it ends up covering up the back glass. I wonder if I can just turn that off. Hey, I can. Cool. Okay. So anyway, I'm going to try playing a little bit of Earthshaker. If you look in the middle of the playfield, right behind that, the middle of drop targets, you'll see the Earthquake Institute. In the original versions of this game, that would actually lower into the playfield. And I do believe this reproduction is supposed to be based on those limited production. The majority... and they made over 5,000 of these. That's a pretty good production run. The Earthshaker Institute did not raise and lower. So if you ever see one out there, be aware that those are rare. Having the raising and lowering Earthshaker Institute means you got a special one.
It's sunny drive time.
So there we go. So the skill shot, the reason I did the skill shot with a slam instead of drawing it back is because in this model, you can almost see it, the ball actually drops into the cabinet if you pull the plunger back. But anyway, so the game's fun. It's got a couple zones. There's a couple of Pat Lawlor signature moves here. So there's a captive ball that's relatively short. Actually, I take that back. The captive ball on the right is not a Pat Lawlor signature. I was thinking about the saucer here, for that's the number 5 shot. having a captive ball of some sort. His use of ramps, you'll very often see a central ramp that feeds back down to the left. I love how he uses the cross playfield flipper shots. And you'll see something, whatever I shot down has definitely broken the scoring on this. So I'm going to show you how the game is broken here. I'm going to pull the plunger back, and the ball just dropped into the cabinet. And you can hear it rolling around there. So, anyway, not the most impressive start to Pat Lawlor's retrospective in his career. I do apologize, but I felt they needed to be addressed, even if I couldn't actually play them. Moving forward, I'll have everything up until his most recent games. So, anyway, so from 1989, we go to 1990 with the next of his disaster games. This one, I have some great memories of a hot summer day, much like today, but today's not his summer. But anyway, I have memories of this hot day, where I was just outside, and or not outside, but in an arcade with no air conditioning, and Whirlwind was the game I wanted to play because it had that fan, and I was really good at keeping this running.
Oh, looks like rain.
Where I could... So I'm going to do a full up. See, I can do the skill shot, which is a short plunge up a little too much there. So the skill shot is the three drop targets in the middle. If you get a sweep of them, you can do it really well. Now, this is theoretically one of the first games that had a wizard mode. Sure, there's other... It's where you actually finish all of the cellar door, and then you get the super cellar door value, which technically is not a mode. So we'll get more into what makes a wizard mode or doesn't as we go on later. But it is important to note that working your way through the cellar door by lighting and making that shot over and over again through the game, I'm trying to catch. I will also say you should be able to backhand the ramp on this reproduction. You cannot backhand the ramp. I think that's a little bit of a shame, because that is a part of the strategy in my opinion.
The storm is coming. Return to your homes.
But, you know, considering danger. I don't have room for games, my buddy Sean's got one of these. And it's set up so you can properly make the backhand. But again, I'm going to call the attention to these Pat Lawlor elements. In this case, we've got scoops, the cellar, if you will, and then a central
the
ramp feed back left. We'll absolutely be seeing more of that as we get later into the games.
The storm is over. All clear. Yeah,
good use of the diverter. The upper flipper gives a really solid... There's actually two playfield shots there. So let's see if I can do a skill shot. Nope. Okay, so the cellar's lit, so I do want to... Anytime the cellar's lit, that's my first priority of the shot. I want to be working on that cellar door. Try to get that super cellar door value. It's not going to happen this game, I'll tell you that. So now that it's not lit anymore, I've used it, I can either relight it by rolling over the right lane, which temporarily relights it, or I can make the left-handed shot, that left ramp. And if I make the left ramp, that... advances the storm, so you know the next. You'll notice the north, south, east, west. So that one lit the northeast light, which I could do southeast by making the right orbit right now. But my cellar's lit, so whenever the cellar's lit, shoot the cellar. What's interesting to me is a lot of this design seems to have elements of the Indiana Jones game, which is a Mark Ritchie game. The parts of that I see are similar are the center ring up to the drop target. Here it's the tornado shot.
Danger! Return to your home!
Of course. Anyway, I'm not going to get into this too much more. Because again, the play field's kind of janky, but it's good to see how, you know, this is a great game. I've had games where I barely break a million. 2 million is sadly kind of average for me. On one that I've been playing for a while, it's not uncommon to go 10 million, where you get a million point shot and you get your multi-ball going. 10 million's kind of an average good game, and I think my personal record is just over 30 million. My buddy Sean's still not too happy because that is up on his machine, and he hasn't come anywhere close to it. Oh, I am going to fire this up one more time real quickly, because there's an important element on the back glass that was first introduced here in Whirlwind. Now, if you look at the back glass, there it is. All the back glass is lit up, and in the Stormblazer's truck, you see a guy hanging out the window wearing a hard hat and holding a red button on a cable. We'll watch for that. We're going to look for that in the back glass. That actually bears a pretty striking resemblance to a younger Pat Lawlor. So if you're curious what Pat Lawlor looks like, this is a little stretched out because I have it stretched for full screen. But that's Pat Lawlor, and he's holding the red button, which is a common element we'll be seeing, and his back glass is moving forward. So anyway, that's Whirlwind. Funhouse is where I really, really became aware of pinball designers. So we're looking at 1990. And I'm at the Pin Expo. This was like the biggest pinball tournament I'd done at the time. I was absolutely thrilled to be there. And thanks to my friend who took me, he introduced me to Pat Lawlor. And you know, Funhouse was the big tournament game that year. They were showing it off. And anyway, I had a personal tour of Funhouse by Pat Lawlor. It was cool. He's a nice guy, and that's where I kind of like pieced together like all these different games had different designers, and there's different things. You know, this design has a lot, again, big key elements. You got a cross-field play shot. This one's neat because you've got two shots. You can shoot Chucky in the face. You can shoot the orbit. You know, I love the opening skill shot where you can possibly get into the step, like the step shot from the back. If not, you can lead onto the right flipper. It's a lot safer than doing the full plunge. If you look closely, you'll notice there's a lot of similarities between this and the much more modern Tron Legacy playfield. Let's fire it up. It's always fun when you play the game. So, you know, the same sort of short plunge. The feed's a little different, but only a little. Oh, you know what? I should have done this as a two-player game. And the reason I'm saying that is...
Hey, Bucko!
I'm Bucko. You hear Rudy call me out. So Rudy calls out different player names. So, if you're playing a four-player game, he'll actually keep track of everybody's name. And you get separate call-outs for each player. So you can get, you know, Bucko, Slick, my memory sucks. So, Chucky, Spunky, Bucko, and Slick. Anyway, it's good fun. Slick is only available in when you've got two or more players, and actually does have some different call-outs. Everybody else, just the same thing, just with the name inserted. So if you ever want to hear Zoom, you need to be playing at least a two-player game. And you have to have Slick to be lucky enough to get Slick as one of the names. You know, here I am talking about it. I'm just going to let it go through. So another thing that's kind of neat here is this is not the first funhouse that Williams made. Williams actually made a much older funhouse, like the 1956.
It's getting late.
Oh, that should have been in.
I'm not happy with you now.
There we go.
Quit playing with the clock!
So, anyway, while I'm still playing around and showing off the game, I am going to say I have a bit more personal connection than just the tour at Pin Expo. From Pat Lawlor. That was pretty cool.
Oh, no.
So about 2 months after that, I'm down in New Orleans. I did a road trip with a friend, and found a little arcade. It was a bar, really. And there was two guys playing Funhouse. And I picked up. I'm like, oh man, look at that guy's head. That's cool. I want to play. And they're like, oh kid, you know, we're playing for $5 a game. You know, you sure you want to, you know, lose your money, you know, play some pinball? And I'm like, I can cover $5. Sure. Anyway, I ended up taking those two guys for about $30, and then looking at the clock and saying, oh, geez, guys, I gotta go. I can't hang around. Sorry. And cutting out of there. So I used my knowledge from Pat Lawlor and my better pinball playing skills at the time to shark some guys out of some money. So that's my second Funhouse experience. So let's do a quick four-player game. We'll get all four players so we can hear all names. So you'd think that those two experiences would be enough to have tied to a single pinball machine. But that's not where my background ends. Couple years after that, I was hanging out with one of my roommates and we're playing some pinball. And we're playing Funhouse. And a guy comes up from the left and says, hey, I want to play. And I'm like, what? You know, wait your turn. And while I'm saying that, the guy from the right says, I like your jacket. I want your jacket. And I'm like, And next thing you know, these guys have another friend, and the three of them are jumping us, trying to sensibly get my jacket, or I don't know what they were after, but... my roommate and I ended up in the hospital, getting some stitches after getting jumped. Maybe that's karma coming back on me for sharking those guys at pinball. Damn it, kind of dumb.
You're making me unhappy.
You'd think that would be enough for me. Yeah, it's like, hey, I've met Pat Lawlor, I've sharked some guys, I've got mugged. That's a lot for one pinball game. But then I go to this is more recent. Nice. Okay. So a little more recently, I met Pinbird.
You don't know what you're doing.
which I believe is the last Tinberg ever. Oh, wow. Well, at least I got the,
stop running around!
Jack.
Hey, Buster, go play on the set.
So, anyway, at Pinburg, this game comes up. So Funhouse comes up in my rotation, and I'm not doing well. I'm down in Division E, playing pinball with the other guys who aren't doing very well. And so I tell him, oh yeah, I've got some connection with Funhouse. I'm either going to do really, really well, or I'm going to tank hard. Well, I'm going to make that part of the story a little shorter. I crushed it. On the Pinburg machine, I think I did like 38 million. Which, I mean, that game is not set up easy at all. But definitely one of my more solid games. Now, one thing I'm going to also, I mentioned with Whirlwind how it had the wizard mode. And it really wasn't so much wizard mode as it was a special reward for completing all the cellar doors. Funhouse actually made it into a wizard mode. So you may have noticed I'm going for the mirror center, that center scoop. And every time you add to the center scoop, or you advance the mirror, you get closer to finishing. Now, with Funhouse, I do believe that this is the first actual wizard mode where you get the super mirror. I haven't even heard what name I am.
I thought we were pals. I'm not happy with you now.
Okay. Hey, thanks for joining, guys, from Wild Dog Arcade. So right now I'm just, playing a little fun house early in my Pat Lawlor career retrospective.
Ow! You're making me very unhappy.
So, I need to figure out what name I've got. I should just trap up and see. FX3 does have some good pins.
That's not funny.
Cool. Okay.
I thought we were pals.
There you go. Ball lock.
Oh,
it's midnight.
No.
So look at this. I'm still on ball one for... ball one for player one. I mean, granted, it's an extra ball, but... it's not that hard to just get dialed into Funhouse once you're there.
Get away from that door! Hey! Go ahead!
Oh no.
So now, normally I do a short plunge here, but because the shot is Rudy's face, I'm going to do a full plunge. Oh, nope. Didn't give it all. So, here I'm supposed to be working on the lower shot, trying to get that orbit, the lower side orbit, which is actually a pretty hard shot to get down. I'd say that's my biggest challenge on this game. But check it out, my mirror's all flashing.
Hey.
So, boom, got the mirror. Mystery Mirror completed. So I got Super Frenzy. So this is, in my opinion, the first wizard mode in pinball. I heard Steve Ritchie making some sort of claim that he had something in high speed, he had a wizard mode in the Getaway, but that came out later. I really should be trying to get some pops and racking up some score there. Every switch is now... There we go. That was good. 3.2 million. So the problem is, other than exploring the steps some more, which I really not really talked about, but I thought was cool. It's a neat feature I don't believe enough pinball machines have used. Offhand, I can think of this and Guns N' Roses as being two games that use left-hand pointers. That's gonna sit for a minute.
It's getting late.
There it goes.
I'm not happy with you now.
I still haven't heard the call out for who the name is.
That's not funny. I thought we were
pals. Oh, come on. When you can get that orbit down, it's really nice.
I'm not happy with you now.
Oh! I was trying to let it bounce across and, that kick is heavy duty. Anyway, the ball won. 14 million is a solid score.
Power on.
And that's the way the pinball bounces. So I'm going to sit here and wait until it calls out my name. I want to hear the name.
Hey, Slick!
This is Slick. Perfect. So player three is Slick. So Slick is the only character that has some unique sayings other than, the same thing just with the name of Slick.
Power on! It's lunchtime!
Let's see what we got.
Power on!
Boom!
Yeah, there it was. That zoom. So you'll only hear that call out for Slick. Oh, come on.
I'm still hungry.
Oh, I missed the hot dog too.
Here it comes.
Smack him in the face. Oh, I missed it. Player three is Slick. So player four, I'm gonna kind of throw player four away. I know. I really went with a four-player game just so I could get Slick.
You can have it back.
Of course, look at me. I can't even intentionally throw a game away. I gotta. It is important to note that some games did have ball saves at this point, but Pat Lawlor does not like them.
Where did you go now?
And there is a little saucer up there behind Rudy's head where you can get Rudy's hideout. It's not a particularly valuable shot. It's a neat skill shot to make. Gets you some points early on without really good work, but really, you're better off just feeding down to the into the right lane and then getting the ball moving. Come on. Thought I'd be lucky to get that mirror.
Hey, Chucky, go play on the set.
Am I? So that's me throwing it away. I still can't just bring myself to throw it away. But I will play Player One seriously, because I kind of would like to get into the high score. I like pushing those. The gangway is neat. I was just trying to go for that. It's a little different than my other strategies, Ben. Shooting the gangway is your left orbit, and if you get that lit, it will advance. And if you get four of them, you can get an extra ball that way. So there's one. So that was the 150,000. Next time I do a gangway, it's worth 200,000. And in this game, you know, those are worth some points. I mean, you gotta work for every million of these. But I should let this drain and focus on alcohol. So I've advanced the clock to midnight. I should note that the original prototype of this actually had a physical clock that would advance up to midnight.
Stay away from the clock.
But they didn't get the mechanics down right on it. It didn't actually work properly in the prototype. And they were working on it right up to the time this went into final production. But it was too expensive, not reliable enough. And what's interesting is they ended up using that clock mechanism in Twilight Zone, which we'll absolutely get to later.
That's not funny.
Oh, I'm just gonna let this drain clear. Extra ball to drain.
Hey, Biff, shoot again!
So you see the gangway carries, but with that extra ball lit, you'll see when I get back here to... Come on, go ahead and drain.
You're making me scared.
Okay, so player two got my Rudy hit. So the extra ball is lit there for him. It's reset for player three. This is slick. Let's see if we can get the other unique call out here. Of course not. I want to show something, and I'm just going to choke. That's how I play it. So yeah, I've had tournament games where I choke so hard I don't even get a million points in the game. That's pretty bad. But for my strategy is just work on the mirror,
let's play two.
And hit Rudy in the face.
You're like a million. Hey, Buster, you're up.
Oh. Well, that's not how you do it. So much for unlimited millions. Okay. And let's see. Get the frenzy when lit. So I can relight the mirror by shooting Rudy in the face. So there is some benefit to shooting him other than just, you know, counting Rudy hits. There we go, two balls locked.
Oh no.
Let's see how this goes. Oh, I like it when I've got it in the hallway. I do love the subway. I mean, it feeds in from the mirror down there to the scoop. So hard to trap this coming out. So I spoiled the arcade where I played this at the most. It would consistently feed out. You could do a dead flip from the right flipper or over the left flipper, crap up, shoot the lock, or bounce it off the super dog and go into the mirror. Let's see what we've got. Extra ball is lit. Okay, so I'm going to drain out. Oh, and this is player two. Notice how it took back, it only took back two steps on my my gangway. But anyway, I'm going to let that go. Okay. So this is slick. So I'm absolutely going to play it so we can see about hearing the slicks. Next ball.
I'm not happy with you now.
There.
Stay away from the clock. I thought we were pals.
Next ball. See where this goes next.
I'm not happy with you now. Stay away from the clock.
So the nice thing with this game is to transfer from the right to the left flipper. You just gotta make the ramp shot.
Shoot again.
Okay. Come on, slick. There we go.
Oh, no.
Let's shoot. Let's smack Rudy a little bit here. Now, in the multi-ball, the other thing you can use to score big points easily is the ramp. Oh, come on. Still not in the body. I've got to turn. Anyway, in VPX, I can absolutely show you how to change the views. Very easy to do. Ramp, left flipper, the hallway, hit Rudy in the face. There we go. Okay. So anyway, that's slick. Funhouse. I'm Did I do well enough to get my name up? I don't think I did, but I will. I'm gonna shoot out here real quickly.
Gangway.
The gangway.
You're making me very unhappy.
Drain. Glasses empty. Okay, so I did get my initials.
Way to go, Buster.
Yeah, high score 3. Not bad. Okay, so saves the game. And then just real quickly, I'm going to do a, just because I've got a request here from email delete. Under the visuals, so if I go to, I'm going to bring this, actually, let me do this. I'll bring that mode up here, and then I'll bring this over here real quickly. So what I've done is, first thing is I click on this button to bring up the pinball playfield view. And then the camera. This is where we get our camera views. So you've got your mode view between desktop, full screen, single screen. So I'm just leaving it full screen. And then my rotation is set for 270 degrees. So that's there's lots of tutorials on how to get a little further into it than that. But the quick thing you need to know is to go to turn into this camera button, go to the camera tab, and the XY rotation will allow you to rotate your play field. So that is what you're after. Hope that helps you. So that's Funhouse. So that was 1990. The next game builds on this in a big way. And now I'm going to point out, Funhouse had over 10,000 units made. That's pretty high. Anytime a game had more than 5,000 units made, that was pretty good production. So 10,000 was pretty good. So you hear me talking about production. That means you probably, if you know anything about pinball, already know what I'm going for from 1992. Come on, where is it? Did I put under A? So here's the Flintstones, the Clyde, there it is. The Addams Family. So the Addams Family stands out. There had been a record that had stood from 1977. So 8-Ball Deluxe was the only flipper pinball machine with more than 20,000 units made. This is the only game. This beat it in 1992 with 20,270 units. That's huge. That is a record that still stands today. I don't see that being broken at any time in my lifetime. So, and also email delete. I used to use a front end. I've tried Pin Up Popper, and I've tried I've stopped using a front end because I spend so much of my time just playing around with this. If I had people coming over and playing it more often, I would definitely focus on a front end, but it's just me. I tinker, so no front end for me. But Addams Family. So this is, I'm going to do a few different things here before I even get into the game. It's awesome because actually Raul Julia and Angelica Houston did record custom callouts for the game. Christopher Lloyd. You're not going to see any reproductions of this because of all of the licensing for all of the likenesses of the actors and their voices. It has just become cost prohibitive. So even though there's more of these out there than any other game, the price is still astronomical compared to other games from the era, if you want to buy it, because it's awesome. It's packed with toys. It's a layout that builds on what Pat Lawlor's already done. And on top of that, this is the first Lawlor game I know that includes fun little things like this. There's Easter eggs. So I'm in the attraction mode right now, right? So if I go, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I hit the start button. Oh, I have free play, so it's going to start. I hit start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1. Still pinball missing. That's not good. So, yeah, I was trying to show you some of the cows that work their way into the games. Why is this not working? Pinball missing. Let me see if I have a different... So what I'm going to do real quickly here, and again, I don't know if I mentioned, but I play around a lot. Yeah, I know. I'm going to go here. Delete the old. Launch. Now, hopefully it finds the ball. And this is, again, one of the joys of a fan-made project. So look at all the extra toys and goodies that are on here. You got Fester in the chair. Still pinball missing, huh? That's weird. Because I have played this. Well, I know that the other version plays better. I'm going to give it like one more kick here. I'm going to call this one old again. Keep that on hand. Glorious troubleshooting. Hooray. Okay. And it's possible that one of the updates may have broken this. Hey, there we go. Got it working. So, anyway, I love this game. So we're going to talk about how Pat Lawlor this is. His skill shot there is nice. It feeds down to the swamp. So if you want something... Oh, thank you. There we go. I appreciate the heads up. I switched to just the back glass view to show how to set up the camera. Anyway, look at all the toys in this thing. We've got the bear, we've got Uncle Fester. So much like Whirlwind, where you had that scoop, I'm going to go for the scoop with Uncle Fester. And this is going to start my modes, and this is going to get me my wizard mode if I can tour the whole mansion. But this is fun because it's got some additional animations in it that weren't in the arcade game. I don't know if you saw Uncle Fester electrocuted there, but that's kind of neat. You'll note that the thing, let's see if I can get up there. Okay, I love that skill shot. Five pop bumpers. And again, much like you get with the Pat Lawlor games, a shot through those pop bumpers. Now, being in those pops is awesome because it raises your grave bumper, which, if you can make that shot, is pretty valuable. Come on. I used to be able to make that all the time. So, I mean, this really is like the perfect mix of toys and theme and the call-outs as well. Oh! Not a fan of the power. There we go.
Now you've done it.
This is one of those games that when you get right into it, you can score some huge points.
Time.
I think my personal best is a little over 2 billion.
Get the jackpot!
See? Come on. I hate the seance. Okay. So I'm not sure why the other balls have gone AWOL. Should be a three-ball multi-ball right now. So obviously something's not playing right. It's funny how I've had more troubles with the Pat Lawlor games than anything else I've played on my stream. Let's try that one more time.
Rest in peace.
Look, everyone, we have guests.
There we go. So that's where you get the graveyard value times 5. So if you're building that graveyard value up with your pops, that's big points. Oh, stop hat. As I was pointing out earlier, there's that Lawlor ramp that feeds back down to the left. So that is another one of those very common elements of a lot of his games. Come on, I want Fester.
Go, man.
Give me that chair. two bears. And out we go.
Have a nice swim.
There we go. Where am I at? Mushka.
Mushka.
Call-outs in this are so good.
Hey,
come on, I can get more pops than that. This is where those 5 pops come in beautiful. What's cool is that it actually learns over time. Ah. It's a little late. That counts for points. Whatever. Let's see if I can get out of the mode. 6 million doesn't suck. Another ball locked. But yeah, I've seen some pretty ragged out atoms out there. There we go.
Now you've done it.
Let's see if it gives me all the balls for the multi-ball here or not. Does it really think it only has one ball in there? Just got the one ball. So officially broken. Which is a shame. Because this is truly a great game to play. So anyway, rather than focus on what's not working, let's move forward. So after making the amazing Addams Family, The very next year brought us, actually, I'm going to turn that off. We don't need that. Brought us another just fantastic Pat Lawlor game. And this is Twilight Zone. Didn't break the 20,000, but there were over 15,000 units made. So again, this is one of those ones you should be able to find fairly easily. It still fetches a good penny because it's a great game. So let's see. I'm going to take it out of the free play mode real quickly because there's some fun attract mode stuff. So if I hit that and then, which ones? Oh, come on. Okay. There we go. That's what I'm trying to get to. I don't want... main audits, main any... come on. I don't want the bookkeeping menu. Okay, I guess that's the way I'm gonna do it. Okay, so I'm not gonna get it to it. I was gonna go through the different cow modes. Anyway, if you're online, take a look. And just look for cows, Twilight Zone, and you'll see some really fun attraction mode. Oh, wait, actually, I think I can do this one here. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. There we go, I got the special thanks. So, Paul Barker, check this out. Anyway, that is one of the attraction mode things. There's one for the design team. You can get debug info, which I'm not going to teach you how to get into. But anyway, I think it's really cool being able to bring that sort of thing up.
You unlock this door with the key of imagination.
So anyway, let's look at where our Pat Lawlor signature work is here. So we've got a shot up into some pop bumpers. We've got a scoop fairly close. This one, it's on the right-hand side instead of the left-hand side. Our left ramp up the center feeds back to the left. Very, very typical. And again, there's a reward for a short plunge. Now, a lot of people in tournament won't do that because it spits up there and it can drain out the side. I do it because it's still fun and it's part of the game.
Are you ready to battle?
Now, I was just reading how there's a magnet that was left out of the production. I'm not sure where it would go here. Oh, so many fun little things in this game. Lots of nods to earlier games. Again, from a production standpoint, here's something kind of interesting. So, I think Universal or whatever held the rights to Twilight Zone, the name. But Rod Serling's estate held the rights to his likeness. So they had to get...
Powerball.
Oh, nice. Powerball. Oh, I love this Powerball. Okay. So now, in real life, the Powerball is only 20% lighter than an actual steel ball. That one's a lot lighter than 20%. The joys of a video game. But yeah, so... anyway, they ended up having to secure rights both for Rod Serling's likeness as well as the actual Twilight Zone property. to think where the other magnet would have been. I don't really see an obvious place for it. And we got the two. Oh, I'll get this again.
You unlock this door with the key of imagination.
And that's why people don't short plunge. What they'll frequently do is just do the full plunge. Of course, it binds for me that time when I was going for it. Let's see if I can make this right orbit.
Not yours. I want it.
So, something fun you can do. If you know somebody who has... I saw this on... Oh, what's the Texas pinball channel? Anyway, some guys in Texas did this, so I can't take all the credit. But what they did is they grabbed five power balls and put them into... Oh, come on, I can't remember the name. I'm drawing total blank. Scott Dinesi's game. Spooky is... It's got some reactors. I can't believe... Total Nuclear Annihilation. TNA. So, pack that up with some power balls and watch it go crazy. The gameplay is so fast then. So anyway, still talking about Pat Lawlor though. Not getting distracted here. So the next game, a year later, comes out. And looking at the success of Funhouse and the mechanisms they already had development sunk into, they made Red and Ted's Roadshow. Which, come on. There we go. Red and Ted Roadshow, 1994. Now, this is really where you start to see the arcades in general are in decline. Great games. Some of the games are better than ever. But home video games, Nintendo is taking a hit. Size changing a bit. So Lawlor did another wide body. Brought out a Roadshow. And they've licensed Carlene Carter to do the voice of Red. She's a country star. You'll hear her music play in the multi-ball. And again, now this one's nice because I have some credits, but let me play.
Time to go to work. Let's fire
so
that.
That's Carlene Carter. Now I should also point out Red's voice is come on, where is it? Tim Kitzrow, who's the same guy who did the voice of Rod Serling in the last game. It's hard to believe it's the same voice actor. There is a skill shot here. If you can short plunge and make it into... I missed it.
Tuesday.
Okay, and I honestly don't know this game as well as I should. It has a lot of those Pat Lawlor standard things. I mean, I always buy all the souvenirs. Because I, of course, assume I'm going to make it through the map, which I never do. But if you buy the souvenir corresponding to the map point that you light up later, here we go. So this is like the Mamushka, same sort of rule set, just hit switches, score points. And always keep that little flipper on the left in mind. You can save yourself some drains that would have drained without my left flipper. There's my skill shot. Get myself a souvenir. Oh man. Okay. So that was pathetic. That was a really awful example of how to play that game.
Heads up.
Okay, so cancel the buy-in.
Don't be a stranger.
Let me see what I'm looking for. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 13, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12. Oh, it didn't give it to me.
Ah.
Nope, no luck. It's not giving me any of the attract mode goodies. Okay, let's put another quarter in. I have to be better than that.
Let's fire that thing up.
Spring break.
Hey, look here, the beach party.
So what I really want to do is get it through that inner orbit there and drop it into the jets. Kicks out, then flip over, repeat. Ah, 37 million, that's like most of my whole game last time. Souvenir shop.
I'm always rolling, baby.
Always buy the souvenirs. Give me a treasure map, sure thing. So again, I've got this short scoop here that I want to be hitting to start the mode.
Fire in the hole. Boom.
There we go. More souvenirs. Box kite, sure.
Paycheck again.
I've never really connected with Roadshow either. Something about it, it almost feels like it's too busy. I'm never, with the other games, I'm very clear what I'm going after. Here, it's like, okay, I can start the modes, I understand how the modes work, but I feel like there's a lot going on in the upper playfield that I just don't know. So,
on our way, baby.
And I love that rubber nose. If you look at it, looks a whole lot like. Oh, why am I so bad with names? I've done another whole special on them. And drain. She is sassy.
Thursday. Boom.
Part of me wants just to get to the multi-ball so we can hear the song. Try another one of these codes here real quickly and then I'll move on. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nope. I guess it's not yet in attract mode. It's still kind of working its way through the end of game, or I don't know. Four, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, I guess you gotta wait for the game over. Well, let me try this one more time. 2, 3, 4, 5. One. Nope.
Forget it.
Okay. So, obviously, I'm not playing well today. See, when I get sent off for work, the end of my day, I look forward to quitting time and getting to enjoy the city. So, but anyway, so that's 1994. At this point, the industry was trying to figure out what to do. it's only implied. So the industry was trying to figure out why they were selling less pinball machines. So one of the theories was that they were taking up too much space. So they came up with Safecracker, which is shorter, narrower, it's a small game. If you ever see one in life, they are pretty cool games. And on top of that, there's a slot that will feed out tokens that you can win during the gameplay. I'm not sure if you can still get more tokens to refill it and how many the game came with, but there was 20 different tokens available. 19 of those were gold, one was silver. So if you get yourself a silver token from a Safecracker, that's kind of special, at least for the original ones. Let's see. So I'm going to try, maybe this one should work. So if I say 1, 1, 2... No, that's so my attract mode codes are not working. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Hey, there we go. I don't know what that's about, but oh, it's hello world and bat in reverse. That's funny. Yeah. So that one worked. And we can, let's see if we can make it moo. 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. There's the moo. Hey, D. Okay. So, Safecracker's kind of a unique game that's on free play. Not only for the size, but for the way it starts. It starts out as a timed game. Oh, and I started in the super mode. That's on me. So this is cool, because you get this timed mode just to score as many points as you can. In multi-ball. So if you want all the excitement of a multi-ball, I mean, they were really pushing the envelope. To attract players and try and figure out what to get more people into pinball. And reality was, it just... The market wasn't there. Society was changing. Until area shut down. There weren't as many pinheads, and sadly, so you can hear the countdown, it says 30 minutes, but it's not real minutes, it's seconds, 20 seconds. Go dead. So anyway, that's the assault mode for Safecracker. I think it's cool to have that kind of mode, and you can go head to head, and especially if it's on free play, that lets you really get some competition quickly. Especially with some of the people I've seen where the gameplay goes on 2.1 million solid. That's not a bad pass. But we want to see the actual gameplay of this, because this is neat. So, again, our Lawlor elements are here. We got a center scoop. Notice the lights on the side of that. The ramp on the center feeds back to the left again. Trying to figure out how to switch. So it's saying I don't have any magic tokens. I know that.
Candy.
Okay.
2000 security system online.
So here we go. So now this is more like you'd expect a pinball machine to be. Now it has some safety at first. So you can see how the countdown's in the middle.
This is a high energy area.
And that's our clock. It's the same sort of clock that they used with Funhouse. Where it's just digital in the middle of the playfield.
Get it, boy. Let's wheel and peel.
So I have 5 minutes back, so that's another 5 seconds. So the difference this time, when I run out of time, it's not going to shut down the machine on me. It's just going to be that when I drain, I won't have any sort of safety.
We don't have much time.
There, so I'm going to drain the ball.
Let's lock them up.
See this? I get to keep shooting, so I'm still into the timer.
Head for the ramp.
Oh, jeez.
Intruder is now in sudden death.
So, anyway, I drained out right as my timer ran out. So it actually gave it to me.
Any mistake will result in complete termination.
Lock is lit.
So what I want to do is I want to hit that ramp.
There you go, dear.
Oh, and I got 20 minutes up back on the clock. That's fantastic. So let's see if I can backhand the ramp.
Lock them up.
Nice.
Be beautiful.
That was not a nice thing to do.
I still get the ball in play because I got those extra 20 minutes.
15 minutes until area shutdown.
You've still got a little time.
Here we go, ball two locked.
Lock is lit. That was special.
What do you think you're doing?
Get going.
There we go. Into the cellar. Oh, so I'm in through the roof. So now this is kind of neat. You can see how there's lights around on the back glass.
We're in the bank.
So I want to try getting into the vault.
Hey, look up and play
so,
the board game.
I'm going to stop the spinning safe. I only move one space. That's kind of awful. Yeah, 10,000. That's not bad. That's some money. So now I'm out in the hallway. I got my cow. Glass of milk. Nice. So now the police are after me, so I don't want to get caught. So we're going to stop and move forward. Four is pretty good. 20,000. So the guard's going to follow me. He gets to roll one. All right. So I move slowly. 12,000, not bad. So a little bit more money, but I want to get in that vault.
He's mine now.
So the police are following me. Let me get this.
Computer-aided watchdog has been released. For your own safety,
okay, so now I've got to get that. It's going to give me the ball back, and I've got to hit one of the scoops again in order to get back in, to escape the dog. So I can either hit the vault in the front shot, or I can hit the cellar towards the back. If I can get the center saucer up there at the top, that counts too.
Please be careful.
So now I honestly don't know what I'm shooting at in the multi-ball.
Oh.
teller's gonna
give
me.
Here you go.
Some donuts. All right.
Want a little helper? The clock is running.
There it is.
That was slick. Let's wheel and deal.
See, I always have a hard time picking favorites. I mean, I'm probably gonna say the Addams Family, just because of how much I connect to that game. That combination of call-outs and gameplay. Although I will say that I haven't played enough of the more modern Jersey Jack Lawlers to really know.
Okay, I'm on my way.
Head for the ramp.
Any mistake will result in.
So, I mean. They're good games in general.
A nice thing to do.
Lot is lit. Head for the entrance.
But. Yeah, definitely. If I could have one game at home, it'd probably be Wonka. Dialed In. You know, I've only played like 6 games of Dialed In, and I've really enjoyed them. I win a lightning bolt. What does that do?
Oh! Heat detected.
I don't think I wanted that lightning bolt. Come on. What am I working on here?
Thanks for your deposit.
That sparkle.
Ah.
It's wheel and deal.
Game over. So anyway, that's kind of interesting because you can have as many balls as you want within the time, but once the time expires, you're on your last ball. So it's a neat mechanic. But
you
I think the game is
terminated.
Limited because of its smaller
have
form
a nice
factor.
Day.
So Safecracker's kind of cool. Is it like a top choice? No, but if I get a chance to play it, absolutely. Where am I at next? Oh. Now, further into the decline of the pinball industry, I will say this is probably my least favorite of the Lawlor games. And this is No Good Gophers. What do we have? Oh, let's see. So here's our No Good Gophers, switch scanning, 0 credits. Good. So with 0 credits, so apparently the prototype had a pop-up gopher, the Smash toy, but that was more expensive than they wanted to deal with. Let's see. If I say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 1, 2. Oh, you said something. I couldn't hear it. Let's try this picture. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Nope, not happening. So let's play it.
Oh, no!
So again, we've got our center shot with a ramp back to the left. It does. This is missing some of the things. I mean, we've got a shot up through the pop bumpers. We got a cross field shot, so it's very definitely. Yeah, I'm doing them in order.
Go pound some sand, Packer.
So I will say that here in 97, when this came out, I was pretty much out of pinball at this point.
Missed.
So I didn't see this until I came. Actually, I think there was a digital version of it in the pinball arcade, if I'm not mistaken. And I played a lot of that before I discovered and built my cabinet. I think I've only seen this in real life maybe twice. Not a very common game. Not a common game to run into. They only made 2,700, so obviously production count was way down here.
Hit the moving line. Use the left flipper. You missed.
Come on. I'm not hitting anything. Wow. I think you have to work to score that low in this game. Honestly, that's... Let's see how
we do. Welcome back!
There's my hole in one. With my first shot, I had not scored more than my whole first game. Brutal. But again, I mean, this really is my least favorite of the Lawlor games. I just have not connected to it.
Go pound some sand and hot shot.
If I go for that center ramp and miss it, it's just right down the middle. Come on, it's just a ramp. You can hit a ramp. Yeah, I don't have any stories to tell about this game. It's... I think there's more to it here than I just know about.
Good job, bud.
Oh, and you know what? Something I pointed out early on that I really should continue to point out. Take a look at the button. If you look at the back left on the left-hand side, you'll see the nice red button being held by one of the gophers. And if we were to go back through all of the... back glasses that I've been playing so far, you will see the red button is a standard item with the Lawlor game. Starting with Whirlwind.
Oh.
Anyway. That's all I'm giving No Good Gophers time for. And I'm sure if I would explore it, I'd probably know more and learn more. But after that, Pat Lawlor was working on a game called Wizard Blocks. Sadly, we will never see it, I don't believe. It was in early production when Williams shut down. I don't know what happened to it. But that is the end of Williams. So that was Lawlor's last Williams games. And it's 4 years later, so 2001, that we see Mr. Lawlor going off and making his first game for Stern. So one of the things I do appreciate that carried over, let's see, I don't see any buttons in the background. I'm just looking in the back glass, see if he tucked it in with all the playfield pieces, but I'm not seeing it in there. Doesn't surprise me that didn't make it. But apparently, let's see, 1-2-1, 1-2-1, 1-2-1, 1-2-1. Secret message! That's awesome. It's literally a secret message. So anyway, the code team definitely carried through the Easter eggs from the Stern times. Let's see what else. And apparently on the smaller, I'm not going to go through it, but look for cows and Easter eggs. There's a ton of fun things in most of Pat Lawlor's games. Now this game I saw for my first time in 2016. I didn't get back into pinball until 2016. So sadly I've missed out on a lot of good stuff. I don't know the rules, but I will tell you that when I was playing this at Pinburg, somebody said, just keep backhanding that railroad shot. You'll do fine. And I was able to just sit and crank it over and over and over again. And making this the only modern game I won on at Pinburg. My modern pinball games are weak in comparison to EMs and solid state. Oh, jeez. Right now, all my pinball appears to be weak. So yeah, it's funny because I ended up scoring like 22 million on this, just spamming the railroad ramp. That was my whole game. Oh geez, that's maybe it was 220,000 or anyways. Bye-bye now. I wanna be a millionaire. So let's take a look at our Lawlor elements here. What did Pat Lawlor bring to Stern? So the pop bumpers, there's six of them, and we do have a shot through the lower pop bumpers. So we have a cross playfield shot with that upper flipper. We've got a central ramp that feeds back down to the left. We've got a scoop off the left. So a lot of Pat Lawlor's trademark elements are in the game. So even without having been told, you know, you could make a fair guess that this is a Lawlor game. Roll. So what's interesting is the game has been nerfed in this digital version, so you can't backhand the railroad. And that was a conscious decision made by the guy who made this digital version, because he knows people spam it as a strategy, and he felt that it's not a good thing. So he intentionally nerfed the backhand, so you cannot make the ramp and do a repeat of my Pinbird game. Okay, you can hit that way all you want. Now we see the left launcher, which gives us shades of Funhouse. Out we go. So it feels like there's a ton to learn in this game. I didn't even really hit the... I'm gonna do this one more time. I have not played this game nearly as much as I feel like I should. I got one cop stop, whatever that cop stop is. Do it again. Stop. I think that little spinning flipper is a neat gimmick. A neat playfield element there. Trying to figure out how to hit this left scoop. Come on. Got my bonus multiplier, got my ball lock. Cool. I feel like there should be a skill shot if I short plunge and feed that upper flipper. Ah! Okay, so I'm getting better at this game. This is something I need to learn how to play. So, here's something kind of interesting. Stern isn't big with releasing production numbers. So this is the only Stern game that we have production numbers on for Lawlor's games. Now, No Good Gophers, they only made 2,700 of those. Monopoly, 3,600. So at this point, things are starting to get a bit more popular better sales at least. So that's a good sign. I really do wish that we could see the sales figures, the production runs on the other Stern games, so we would know, how many of each one are made. Even with the special editions and limited editions and pro editions and all that going on. I think there's a lot we can see about what's going on in the industry based on how many sell. It's hard to say. I would guess AC/DC would be the top selling Stern so far, but that's a guess. Maybe Metallica. You know, just AC/DC had so many versions. But yeah, one of those two would most likely be the top seller. But they've had some good modern games, you know, maybe Tron. But I'm willing to bet none of those. Well, Jurassic Park's only been around for a year so far. So, I mean, I don't know that Stern can produce in that volume yet. It's weird to think you take that comparison and Spooky considers 500 units a year's production. Meanwhile, you know, Stern is making probably 500 a month, I would guess. Again, I haven't been in touch to see where things have been streamlined modern day as much. So earlier, after Monopoly is definitely a solid game. Now this game, next game gets a bad rap, and I haven't really understood why. I have played it a bit. I've actually probably played it more than Monopoly. And this is Roller Coaster Tycoon. Roller Games, there we go. Roller Coaster Tycoon. So, one of my best memories of this is, I don't know if you ever listened to the Pinball Nerds podcast. Orbital Al owns one of these. And I stopped at his place out in Nova Scotia while I was out there on a road trip. And we sat and we played this and, you know, drank some craft beer and just had a good time hanging out. Short plunge says, oh, not short enough. Give me the ball back. Come on. I would love to shoot the lit ramps. Give me the ball back. You know, and it's funny because you talk about sounds being grating, and absolutely. Sight and sound package makes up a lot of what makes a good game. This really surprises me as a license. I mean, Roller Coaster Tycoon was a pretty good selling video game at the time, but I don't think it had the It's not like there's a musical theme or a main character to connect to. It's just like, look, we're doing roller coasters, and you know what? We can make rails and make them like roller coasters. Why are you crashed? Oh, I'm using the wrong one. There we go. Let's see if this is any better. Okay, so my back glass is working. That's good. But, you know, it's like when people talk about why is the Addams Family one of the most popular games of all time, I think a really big part of that comes down to the call-outs. You've got Angelica Houston, Raul, Julia making just incredible call-outs. You know, so, you know, add that in with some theme-integrated mechanics, and it's just an incredible game. You know, here, I don't know how the troll fits in with this theme. Why do we have a troll in the playfield? But, from a shooter standpoint, I don't want to hit. Oh, shoot the dummy. You know, it's too bad that we lost Python D'Angelo. Honestly, I think if they had brought Python in to do the artwork and code for this, I mean, except he's dead, so it's not an option. Yeah, and I can believe that Stern would slap the license on for an unlicensed funfair game. It's weird because Stern has actively avoided licensed games. I mean, even their one unlicensed title is technically licensed title because, Black Knight is an old licensed product from the 80s. So, you know, people buy them. They buy the license. Although this is like a bizarre license to work with. And again, it's borked out on me. Anyway, Roller Coaster Tycoon, good shooting. I love the ramps and the roller coasters. The license is bizarre. It makes me realize how much we lost when Python passed, because imagine Python's artwork tying this all together. Yeah, Monopoly, everybody, you know, you say Monopoly, people are going to close their eyes and they're going to see the millionaire. They're going to see the car. They're going to see the iron. So at least with Monopoly, people will close their mind, close their eyes, and immediately vision the game and some of the characters with that. I'm not so sure I'd include Whoa Nelly as a Stern game. I know they manufactured and distributed it, but it certainly was not a Stern production initially. High Roller Casino, yeah, that is their... For some reason, it has a licensed feel. Well, okay, yeah, old school. You're going back to the 70s. And really, when you're looking at the old Stern before they went to Data East... actually, did somebody buy them before Data East? Yeah, anyway, so it all goes back to Chicago Coin. So, sadly, my Roller Coaster Tycoon doesn't work, which is turning out to be a trend with these virtual reproductions of the Lawlor games. Let's see if we have any luck here with Ripley's. So again, here's another bizarre theme. This one actually works a little bit better, I think. Ripley's Believe It or Not, 2004. What's interesting here is that you'll notice in the corner of the back glass, PLD. So that's Pat Lawlor Development. So this one's kind of fun because it really does develop some characters that you can get into, whether you think of it as Ripley's or not. The shrunken head has a personality to it. The dog, so there's a lot to this game, and as well as a lot of our typical Pat Lawlor things. You know, we got a short scoop here on the directly above the left flipper. A central ramp that eventually feeds down to the left. There's another ramp here. The Vera target's kind of neat. I was mentioning PLD on the back glass. That is Pat Lawlor design. So at this point, rather than being an employee directly of Stern, Pat Lawlor had his own design company. The URL is still out there, but it doesn't connect to anything. So Pat Lawlor design, and it's interesting to see how things changed a bit there. And we'll see. I'll get into the Pat Lawlor design a bit more moving forward. Right, let's play some pinball. This skill shot's awesome. Again, Pat Lawlor very definitely likes his skill shots. center ramp.
Get playing around.
Okay. Now let's hit the Vera target if I can. Nope.
Shoot the left ramp.
But yeah, so the callouts work on this. Center ramp.
Break the magic code.
Two times scoring.
Double your fun.
Travel the world.
It's time to visit Africa.
This is fun because you've got your different modes to work on.
A ramp shot.
Which, this is definitely something that Pat Lawlor established, the progression of different modes to lead up to a final wizard mode.
Time's running out.
Ah!
10.
So yeah, we can trace the ancestry of all the modes right back to Funhouse. In the magic mirror where you get the wizard mode at the end. Jeez. And another thing Pat Lawlor hates is ball save. So right there, no ball save. This is a wax build. People who are familiar with the... Seriously. So people who are familiar with the visual pinball scene may have heard the name Wax, or you may hear me talk about his gameplay. He does dial them in to be a bit more challenging than the original builds. I find the physics are more realistic. Let's do this again. I only did one continent. So it's a good question. How do you get a wax game?
Looks like
so, if you've ever watched Pinball Undesirables stream on Twitch, you'll note Pinball Undesirables has a Discord channel. And Wax
it's time
is
to visit
on
Africa.
The Pinball Undesirables Discord channel.
A ramp shot.
And you can get the games directly from him. In Discord. And that is the only way I know to actually get them.
Jackpot! 10.
Collecting an idol would be good now.
Points everywhere! Six. Five. That's so weird, Mom. The temple gate is open, Mom. Three. Shoot the left ramp. One.
Extra ball is lit.
Extra ball is lit.
Choke, because this is what I do. Yes, I do.
Game 4, man.
There we go. Got my extra ball.
Extra ball!
So I will also point out that Wax does have his own Twitch stream where he just streams music.
Try a ramp shot.
Usually late at night. He'll do a big DJ set.
Keep going, man. Give me a P.
Yeah, definitely. See, and this is where I'd love to know how many of these they play, how common the game is. So I don't think there's a lot of these out there.
Break the magic code.
Give me an O.
Ball.
Sure, why not?
Extra ball is lit.
Look at that. Now
extra
I think
ball. It.
Now it is weird to me to think of that as a Vera target. Because for me the Vera target was always
visit Antarctica.
A straight line that had a pressure to it so that
it's not plugged in yet, man. Jackpot! Oh, that's gonna hurt!
Get up there.
There. Jackpot! A little too slippery for me. Don't forget the penguin.
Okay, where do I hit next? Antarctica's not bad.
Lock is lit, man.
Okay, ball locked.
Ball one locked.
Blew it. Good thing I got those two extra balls. So this looks like a fantasy back glass because the colors in the eyes of the idol are changing. I don't believe it might have done that in the real one. Seriously.
Shoot again. Many things worth collecting.
Okay, let's do a tour.
It's time to visit Asia.
Oh, seriously? That was short-lived. I'm gonna do a full plunge. Okay. It does take it up there. I have not hit the skill shot at all yet.
It's time to visit Europe. Weird gravestones, my favorite.
Oh, I hit the tombstones. Got it. That's hilarious.
10. 9. I can dig it. See, the temple gate is open.
The temple gate is open.
Ball 2 locked. Multiball is lit.
Hit me to party.
Okay, let's go party with the... I love how they use the magnet for the shrunken head. Road trip? What do I do with road trip?
Time for a road
all
trip.
Shots add jewels.
A fast way to add jewels to my collection.
Extra ball lit again? Seriously?
Extra ball is lit.
So this is where in tournaments I'm so happy that that the extra balls are not enabled.
Extra ball.
Because I mean it's awesome. If I'm dropping coin and I want to play a game where I've gotta, you know, get the most for my money, extra balls are awesome. But when I'm playing in a tournament, I don't want all the extra balls. Look at all the jewels.
Shoot again.
Let's go for a trip. Oh, come on, I want that trip. There we go.
It's time to visit Australia.
The boomerang.
It's an incredible map.
Who would have taught that? Careful. Double points.
Two more to go.
Oh, that's right, we gotta hit the bear target 3 times. There we go.
Another jewel for my cup.
Oh, and I totally brain farted on that one. That was... I don't know what was going on there.
Shh.
shoot again.
Well, the nice thing is, with it said it's easy, I'm likely to get to the wizard mode, actually.
It's time to visit South America.
Ball so I can get to shoot. Oh, I'm losing my points. There we go.
Sure, pick on the little guy.
Okay, so 50 million is the highest score, which seems respectable to me, but I know I've done way more than that. There we go. That's what I'm trying. So, had I done better in the different modes, this would be scoring a lot more points for me right now. But it seems like I choke whenever I hit one of the modes, so all of this is fairly low.
That was awesome.
End of game. So it's not a high score, it's like halfway to the high score, but 25 million is respectable. I
did it. Did it.
Go. So anyway, that's Ripley's. Absolutely solid game. Brings into existence the Pat Lawlor designs.
Believe it or not.
So we definitely see things changing here. Stern's changing the focus of their business. And obviously it's a better license than they had for Roller Coaster Tycoon. Based on that, we end up getting one of the more lucrative licenses, NASCAR 2005. I really like this game. And let's see. Oh, this brings back our, what's it called? So this brings back our Easter egg. So let's see if I can get this done here. So we've got my track screen going. So 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 1. Secret message. It literally is a secret message. I guess it's all they got in there. So this is a real break from Lawlor Designs. So there is a central ramp that does feed back to the left, but I don't see any scoops up front, so there's no short scoops. There's a scoop in the middle, which, you know, definitely breaks from design. There's no cross-field play shot, so no upper flipper. So if you haven't told me if this was a Pat Lawlor game, or if I didn't know to look for that PLD logo in the corner of the background, then I would not have known that this is a Pat Lawlor game. I do enjoy that they reuse some of the sound effects from these other games. Come on, I can hit a center shot. Center shots are my weakness in games.
We're picking up chat.
I have always had trouble with center scoops. So this is fun. So NASCAR was sold in Europe as a European release. They sold it as Grand Prix. And there was a follow-up using the same playfield, new artwork, for Dale Jr. Now, I had originally heard that Grand Prix was a European exclusive. Ah, simultaneously, out it goes.
Great shot. Block is lit.
And obviously I have to fix the plunger. See how far forward the plunger sticks? That was actually preventing the auto launch from working. So I had to pull the plunger back mid-game to get the auto launch to work. So here I'm going to pull that out. So, even though it doesn't have a lot of the Pat Lawlor details I would expect, especially the cross-field shot, it's still a decent game. I like this orbit that, you know, spins the ball around and... Overall, I think they may have been trying to cut costs in production. I mean, seriously, you look at how many toys there were on, you know, back at the height of things. And Twilight Zone just packed the gills with toys. This one's kind of fun. I mean, it's got a Bash toy, it's got that orbit thing. Get some ramps.
Shoot the left orbit. Shoot the left ramp.
It's time to rock and roll.
Gentlemen.
Thank you, Sammy Hagar. Couldn't get the super jackpot. how we do here.
Super Jackpot is lit.
So I guess what interests me the most, if you were to look at the design elements of this game and ask me who I thought designed it, I mean, we've got that left-hand saucer, we've got orbits with ramps, big fan layout, pop bumpers are kind of just tucked away up there, almost an afterthought. I'd say I was looking at a Steve Ritchie game here. There's definitely a lot of flow. And it keeps things moving.
He's moved into a place.
And of course the car theme is absolutely a Steve Ritchie thing too.
Bump and run!
Out we go. It's a good game, though. Like I said, it just doesn't line up with that Pat Lawlor experience I've gotten used to. It doesn't have any... doesn't have the red button on the back glass. That seems to have gone away with the Stern games. All right. And ball save came in. I mean, that's... So yeah, that's NASCAR. So where do we go from here? We're almost done with what I've got. So from NASCAR... So this is... kind of an interesting. I mean, I'm going to play a few of them because they are different enough. So, anyway, continuing with some great licenses, we've got Family Guy. Come on, I know I have Family Guy, don't I? I don't have Family Guy. So, that's okay. So, Family Guy. What's interesting is... and I'm sorry I can't show it, but Family Guy was actually kind of when Pat Lawlor Designs ended as an organization. So my understanding is that during the production of Family Guy, they had the white wood done, but they were working on the coating. And Stern took it away from Pat Lawlor's team. So the final coding was actually done by Stern through their department rather than the Pat Lawlor Designs. Now we do see the Pat Lawlor Design logo in the corner here. So they're still involved at some level. I mean, this is obviously a Pat Lawlor Design playfield. Again, looking for our Pat Lawlor elements, we've got our left ramp. It's kind of central-ish. It feeds back to the left. There is a scoop here, the Danger Ogre scoop that goes in. This is also kind of interesting because that is an actual recording of Smash Mouth in the opening of the game. For the rest of the game, they're using all remastered, re-recorded stuff. But it's uncommon to have the actual band recorded, especially in a non... that's right. So this game is broken in a lot of ways. And I'm talking about the visual product, reproduction of it. So it doesn't function with my plunger. See if I can get to the little play field up there. That's kind of fun. donkey.
Oh, they sound just like their daddy.
That was amazing, princess. Can you show me how you do that?
Ah, I see you admiring my fine footwear. Do I see a challenge before me?
There we go.
Well, you win some and you lose some. And you lost.
But again, this... it's weird. The game actually has a kind of generic feel to it. Again, if you told me this was a Pat Lawlor design, I have a hard time seeing it. It's not that it's a bad game, it just... There's our scoop. Donkey Multiball.
Finally, it's my turn to shine.
Let's get it.
Oh, come on, I'm just having fun with you.
Ah, whizzes on you guys.
How ye ogre. Pray for mercy, Flop. Puss.
A whoops.
The only thing worse than ego is his singing.
Can I tell you about
that? Two of them.
Gingy and how much he hates milk. Well, I guess that high score is far, far away now. That was a bullseye.
I should be able to hit that ramp. Merlin! Do your thing.
You must carry on for all of us.
So this is I've actually only seen Shrek in person. Oh, that's right, it doesn't work. I think I've seen it in person like two or three times.
The sting of my sword.
Well, at least we know where the princess is.
When Pinocchio lies, it's as plain as the nose of... Ooh, that makes the ground shake! Five, four, three...
Taste the sting of my sword!
Five...
What are you doing in my swamp?
Guess what? Multiball! Shoot for the extra ball!
Oh, there it is.
Ooh! That came from the diaphragm.
Sense pedestrian fighting skills.
Shrek's swamp.
So with the rickety bridge over the lava, I pretended to be scared, you know, to distract Shrek from the danger.
Oh yeah.
You cross the bridge, or you cross me.
I remember why. Which I don't is have, it? Family Guy.
I don't want to end up a crispy critter now. You know, I'm thinking we shouldn't cross until we have this bridge surveyed. Stop the bridge, I want to get off.
Once upon a time, there was a happy little gingerbread man.
All that, and she makes a mean slug stew.
Taste the sting of my sword.
I
There's that extra ball.
Look at that. You got an extra ball.
Come, knights, and meet your doom at the hands of Boots in Boots.
What's wrong? Do I have your tongue?
I'll get back to the mini pinball again.
How would you like your pants carved? Thick or thin?
That no good charming, he really burned my batter!
Here we are, more mini pinball.
Oh, this is gonna be fun. We can stay up late, swapping manly stories, and in the morning, I'm making
waffles. They're clearly not Eddie Murphy.
Too charming, deal with it.
Charming to you, maybe.
Is that a glass of milk you have?
Oh, good job. Now leave me alone. Yes, she's beautiful. And she's mine.
Half inspiration, half perspiration.
More deodorant.
Okay, so I got one more to go. I got the letter A to finish.
Why does that
Fiona
always seem to happen?
So close there.
Today, you have met your match, señor.
Ooh, I feel bad for the guy who tries to fight Fiona.
Give me all 1, 2.
Prince Charming.
Quick, tell a lie.
Yeah, perfect match, you know that?
I shall discard you like a furball.
All right, who put that there?
Not bad. Picking up the game finally a bit. Oh, I can't believe I just missed one letter to finish the pinball machine up there.
Oh, don't look now, but you've got another ball.
Oh, Jack and Spell.
Taste the sting of my sword.
It's like a party in here.
The only thing you're ever gonna be king of is king of the stupids. That no good charming, he really burns my batter.
Come one, come all. Taste the sting of my sword. I will face anyone, anytime, anywhere.
Out we go.
Oh,
okay.
I feel something brewing. So. Kinda juicy.
Shrek, not bad. So, Shrek is built on Family Guy. Apparently, they also did a one-off re-theme of this for Good Morning America.
I hate it when you got somebody in your face, you're trying to give them a hint, and they won't leave. And then there's that big, awkward silence, you know.
Okay. So, anyway, there goes Shrek. And it would be interesting to see or get a chance to play the Good Morning America re-theme of that. So this brings us to the end of Pat Lawlor's association with Stern. So in 2008, understanding things had been rocky with the software team and the development, we still see the PLD logo up there. So this is Pat Lawlor's last game with Stern, which I think this was kind of where pinball was actually starting to get more popular. I guess pinball started to get popular again in 2013. So the production numbers weren't there. Again, looking at this,
as Lord Byron
it's
once
hard
said,
to see the Pat Lawlor elements to this. I mean, it's a good game. There's a lot of toys. A lot of things going on. You got a cross playfield shot there. Center shot that feeds to the right. This time it's to the left. Yeah, short scoop. So I guess the Pat Lawlor elements are present. Ah, oh, missed the skill shot. So one thing I find interesting with this game is they actually got new callouts recorded by the guy who played the coroner on the show. I don't remember his name.
You right? Haven't suffered some blunt force trauma recently, have you?
So, yes, whoever the guy is that played the coroner in this, I've only seen like one or two episodes. He actually did record the callouts for Stern. Oh, still missed it.
Impressive. I was ready to process you for the morgue.
I've played this in real life maybe three or four times. Definitely, it's a neat game, and one that I don't think people see often enough.
All right, I want everybody to think in worst case scenario. Complete DNA, the light DNA lab.
Hey. And so, after this, it was like 9 years before we saw another Pat Lawlor pinball machine come out. This time from Jersey Jack.
Catherine.
So, I'm going to keep playing CSI. Because I don't have dialed in or Willy Wonka available. Now, I will say I've played maybe 10 games of Dialed In, and I feel like there's a huge amount of depth to that game that I need to explore. It's awesome. It's another one in his Disaster Series following. In the tradition of Earthshaker and Whirlwind. It has the red button. So while we've got the themes connected with all the Stern
DNA, the light DNA lab.
I definitely feel that Dialed In does a good job of bringing
green evidence is lit.
Pat Lawlor into the modern age. It's got some of his trademarks reworked with newer building and game design technique. He's really stepped forward with
TOD
with
is
Dialed
now.
In. And then even with Willy Wonka, still takes great classic elements. But honestly, this isn't a bad game to be from the time it's CERN.
This is timepiece.
Come on, I can hit that. I want to hit the centrifuge. There we go. Alright, look at that. That's a really cool little thing. Hey. Okay. So I'm going to play a game again, and I'm going to go for the lab, which is going to start my mode, which is what I expect from a Pat Lawlor game. That was really bad. I didn't do the pop-up skull.
The rule of three. Three pop-up bumpers and three multi-balls. This player might be ready for the morgue.
AV Lab Award. Nice.
Maybe AV can give you something.
see if I can hit this lab shot. There we go. That's what I was after.
Markers on the DNA reveal something interesting.
Million points. Sweet. Doubles my score.
Green evidence is lit.
Okay.
Complete DNA to light DNA lab.
Almost there. Out we go.
Presence of fleas suggests this Vic laid with dogs.
What am I doing? Oh, it's after six. There we go. I got the eye in the skull. About time.
Lock one.
First, let me take a selfie. Out we go again. Yeah, I remember the one tournament I played this at. I was like, I think I just barely broke a million.
Well, maybe an autopsy can tell us something. Microscope is lit.
I think the vehicle was making a tree.
There we go. Twos. I got the skull multi-ball. Awesome. And that is cool.
Is lit.
I hit the centrifuge. So this is a cool game. I could absolutely spend a lot of time getting to know this. You know, and I do feel the Lawlor. I mean, if it's close to anything, I think it's close to Twilight Zone. The callouts are a little bit weak, I hate to say it. But I think it's the theme of the game. It fits. Overall, yeah, a lot of fun. Definitely can see where Lawlor's into it. It's busy, and that's the part of it that makes it feel like a descendant of Twilight Zone to me. But anyway, for anybody who's tuned in today, I thank you for, you know, sticking around. You know, I,
we'll be doing more streams in the future, and it's good fun. And where am I at? Oh yeah, that's fun. Anyway, stay healthy, keep flipping, and I'll see you next time.